had my head spinning. Just so you guys know, I'm still in the same weight class, about 220. Jeepers, you got all that stuff shaking everywhere. Holy cow. I love it, though. I love it. Like many of the others have said, just to see a lot of friendly folk in here and smiley faces is pretty exciting for all of us. The support that we get from our fans, alumni, and just community is what make this place special. And so to get to see our student athletes rewarded by people in the stands, that's where they get their excitement and that joy of really playing is for you all. So we too are looking forward to that. It was really interesting listening to Coach Wood talk about her team and how she has everybody back. And we do too. And throughout this fall and throughout this summer, like Coach AJ says, you really have no off time. What I've learned is, even though we have most of our guys back, all but Willie, every year is different. Every year is different, and no matter what, you still have to find those character traits that what are going to make this team special. And you know, our team has really embraced the work, the togetherness that we believe is really, really important for our success. Has been important and will continue to be important for Jackrabbit basketball. Our fall has been terrific. Our practices they've been very, very spirited. Our depth, I believe, this year is something that we haven't had maybe in the past, and that's going to be one of our strengths this year is our depth. We have, you know, in our practices, you know, there are some battles, and guys are battling for minutes, and we're going to be in situations where some really, really good players, you know, may not be playing the minutes that they think they should or they like. And that's where you have to have that trust, that selflessness and togetherness to get through those tough times. And we talk about selfless all the time with our group. And this fall, they've been terrific, but it's going to be important as we go forward, too. As far as health-wise, I know Dougie's back there is with us today. And like AJ was saying, you really never know on timetables. But Doug, you know, as many of you know, struggled throughout the whole last year to recover from that foot injury, and to have him back being our only senior, healthy, firing around in practice, and his leadership has been terrific. So we're super excited to be more healthy than we ever have been. Charlie's just getting back in practice for the first time. He broke his hand earlier in the fall, and so we should be all ready to go as our games start on next Tuesday. 8 days from now, we'll be tipping that baby up. I can't wait. But as far as, you know, leadership on our team, I've already mentioned Doug. And Doug may not be the most vocal dude at practice, but the energy that he plays with, the example he sets for our younger players is terrific. And that's something that is unmeasurable. Alex Arians, Matt Dentlinger, two other guys that are in their fifth year of their program, but only juniors on the court, which is great. But they're very, very similar. They're very similar, the how they play, the selfless attitude that they bring to our team is really, really special. So we're so fortunate to have great leaders. We have, you know, and to bring in a couple new guys. You know, Zeke Mayo from Lawrence, Kansas, has had a terrific fall and summer with us. And his ability to, you know, make plays and get downhill and get to the free throw line is something that we necessarily haven't done a great job with in the last couple of years. And he just brings a little bit different dynamic player in that sense. So we're really looking forward to seeing what Zeke can do this year for us. And then Broden Lean's another young kid from Flum, Minnesota. Big, big size dude that can really stretch the floor and make shots from the perimeter. And, you know, sometimes it takes those big guys, speaking from experience, a little bit longer than others. But Broden's, you know, had his growth has been fun to watch as well. Our schedule, I'll tell you, AJ talked about it, Damian talked about it. Our guys are going to get challenged, and we're excited about that. This is like the other guys, as hard a schedule as we played, but the experience that we've had, the guys that we have on this roster, I think it's good for them. They need to be challenged every time they step on the floor, and they will be. And it starts, you know, next Tuesday with Bradley. We have, you know, some good home non-conference games. Get to play in Sioux Falls three times, you know, before the holidays, which is a great experience for our guys. But we're looking forward to those challenges, and we're looking forward to doing it together. And we're certainly looking forward to do it in front of all of you. So we can't wait to get out on the floor and go Jacks.